So that was good. I think we got a good handle of sales trends. Then we saw the thing by gear assembly. So we did some product portfolio type of thing. Now, there is also this thing about regions, right? We have some information about regions, regional information. So can we see the regional distribution of revenue? I mean, that is the only thing that is missing. I think if you get some color of the regional distribution of revenues, then I think we, and there's some question about how many agents should we have and all that. So I guess regional distribution of revenue is important for assigning agents, right? Sales agents. You've got to look at the revenue in the region, and according to the revenue, you have to place agents. Either you could do, you could divide revenue by something and then put the agents like that. You could decide how many agents in each region, right? So, so we need a regional distribution of revenue.
Yes.
So another pivot table, I guess. Pivot table.
It's a little bit more tricky than that. Okay, so let me share my screen. So now one of the peculiarities is that this data is actually now in a different sheet. This is the data that was given us. But given you can see months. That
he's given it for 3 months in a different sheet.
He's given, he's given it only for 3 months. But more importantly, GV, he has given it to us in a completely different Excel sheet.
Okay.
So now, if we want to look up prices, if we want to look up revenue, etc., we will not be able to look it up in this because that data is in a different sheet.
Oh, I see. Okay. So, but you have the name.
Now, so the simplest thing to do is here,
and also this is October 2019 and that is written in something else. Huh? What is it written in that sheet? What is it? It's called something else.
Yes. So the best thing to do, first thing to do is we should move this data into that sheet. Okay.
How do you
do that? Of course, it is possible to look across multiple sheets also, but right now, for the sake of simplicity, we will just copy this sheet into the other sheet that we were working. So how do we do that? We go to this tab and we do a right click. And then we can say move or copy. You can see my screen. You can see the pop-up.
Yeah.
So you say move or copy. And now we say we want to create a copy, but we want to create it in the classwork sheet, which is the sheet that we were working.
Okay.
So we'll call this tab region-wise data that. So naming tabs, etc., is actually quite important because it helps you keep track of what you're doing.
Hmm.
Okay, now let's see what do we want. What we want, my understanding, GV, is we want a table where, let's say, the rows are regions. And the columns are, what should the columns be? Months.
Yeah, October 2019, November 2019, December 2019, total.
Right. Quarter. So October 2019, November 2019, December 2019.
And total.
So now, and a total, yes. And a total. So now we want to know what were the total units sold in the north in October 19. Okay. So first thing is that data is not available to us here. So we will have to, in this table, we will have to add a total row. Right.
You can't do a pivot here, is it? Because the problem is, why can't we do pivot? Because well, October 19 is the header of, it's not an entry in the column.
Yes.
It's the header of the column. That is the problem. If it had been an entry in the column, if you had a row which said October 19 like that,
Correct.
You know, it had been entry as a sale entry, then you could have done it. But correct. You can't do it. Okay, this is like the like what we saw earlier. This is like the result of a pivot table.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. So really, there are two options here. One is that we can go back to the ERP and try and get data in some nice form.
Ask them to regenerate it in form. Yeah.
But this problem is a relatively small problem, so we can just try and quickly do it without getting that. Okay. So now we can see that we have north 16,230 numbers in October. East is 17,135, west has 5,5985, and south has 14,308. Now, one of the things we can do, GVE, is we can copy this.
No, we shouldn't do that. Look up, or something.
No, in this case, we'll have to copy.
Why can't you look up? And I can look up.
Because what you want here, everything is in columns. And I want to copy this in rows. So here, everything is in one row. Here, I want it in one column.
Oh,
so think of it as a transpose of a matrix.
Why don't you write north, east, west, south in the column and up?
Because this is the format which they want to review it.
That you can write and then you can transpose the matrix. Can't you transpose?
So I was going to do it at one shot, but you're right. We can do it like that. You're right. So I can do it like this. Can do cut.
Keep that. Okay, fine.
Okay, we'll keep it. So what did we say we will do? We will do east. Sorry.
You can just say equal to north, and put equal to and point it to north, that. Okay.
West, south.
Milan, why don't you say that for north labels, why don't you say equal to and point it to that? That way, you can just drag
it. Then I won't be able to drag it.
You can. No, not there. You point it to the north of that previous table.
Oh, okay.
Then you can
drag it. I can.
That one, yeah. Yeah.
Okay. And here I'm going to say October 2019.
Here you have to write. There's no choice.
Here there is no choice. And now here I would say this. This would be here.
Yeah. Yeah, at least some work you reduce. It's not.
Yeah. But now you see, we've got this. This is actually a good starting point. But what we have to present to Shiv is actually a transfer. Okay. Now, the good news is that Excel will allow us to do this very easily. Which is, we can just cut this table and we paste.
While pasting your transpose, no? Yeah.
And we say transpose. No, so you have to paste it as values. Yeah. Paste. So actually, what you have to do is go into paste special. You say, I want to paste values. And when you are pasting it, you transpose.
Yeah.
And you got what you wanted.
Yeah. Yep.
Okay. So, this way, we've now got what we need to do is to, okay, so first of all, here, let's add a total row. Now, the next problem, GV, that Archana was trying to solve before that, she wanted to figure out how many sales agents to have, right?
Correct.
And what I remember discussing is that the number of sales agents will depend on the maximum volume that the region sells in a month. So we have to design the number of sales agents for the busiest month in some sense.
Yeah. I thought he said some 5,000 units a person can sell in a month or something.
Correct. But that is in the busiest month. So not in an average month. So we need to find out what is the maximum sale over these last 3 months.
Oh, okay. I see.
Let's figure out what is the max monthly sales.
Okay.
Now, if you want to compute max, actually Excel has a function called max. And it will tell us. So in this particular case, it is 16,645, which is what happened in November.
Right. You can't take average because the guy has to be able to handle the maximum peak. Okay, I understand.
Correct. So if you just drag this, then we've got the max monthly sales. And note that it may not necessarily, in this particular case, it all happens to be November. But it could be something else. An example, if I said this was 20,000, then it could be. Now let's go back. Okay, so what did you say? You said sales per agent is 5,000.
Yeah.
Sales per agent, we'll create a cell, and in that cell we just say 5,000. And then we can compute number of agents needed.
Okay.
So what do we do? We do this divided by, and this of course we'll have to, for D14 we'll have to put $.
Yeah.
But you can't really have 8.3.
You take ceiling of that.
The way to do that is to say there's a function called roundup.
Give
you the next integer. It will give you the integer that is above 3.3.
Okay.
And we want zero decimal points, zero digits after the decimal point.
Correct.
So we'll put zero.
You can't have fractional agents.
Correct. As an example, if I put one here, let's just see what happens. I would have got 3.4.
That's not working.
Okay, but that doesn't make sense, right? So we will make this as zero.
We need four agents. Yeah.
Okay. So what this tells you is that you need four agents in each region, except in West, where you can do it too.
The interesting thing is that if you have done total, just do the max for the total and do the number of agents if you do the total.
Instead of max, you do the total.
No, I'm just saying, just take the max of the totals. Just drag that 16,691.
Okay.
I just want to, and drag that four thing also down. So you got 13, but 4, 2, 6, 4, 10, 14. So you can't have 13 agents. I mean, it looks like you can, if you did only analysis of the total, you'd have got 13 agents, but clearly you can't manage with 13 agents because how do you distribute this? You need.
Across regions, distributing would have been difficult.
Because the agent is going to sit in some city, right? He'll sit in Bombay or Pune or whatever. So you can't, or Delhi, Chennai, whatever it is. Regionally, they'll be located.
Yes.
So you need 14 agents. So 13 is, so actually you're going to get 14 because you have to sum up the 4, 2, 4. You get 14.
Correct.
So the effective amount of sales per agent.
It is to actually do this. No, sorry.
You have to sum the. Correct. 14. Yeah. So if you take 14, if you divide 16,671 by 14, you get the effective sales per agent, actually.
That is correct. That is one way of looking at it. Yes.
You will not get, it will not be 5,000. Just right. You get something else. You'll get 4,000 something.
You can say. Actually, I can do this for each region.
There will be 5,000. Oh, no, it may not be because you're rounded up.
No, it's not. It's not because I rounded up.
Yeah. We can do it. Yeah.
Okay. But the other thing that Archana wanted, GV, is what is the financial outlook, if you remember? That's what she wanted. Right? And what you told us, I think, was that cost of sales agent she had said was 80,000 rupees, no?
Per month?
20,000 rupees. Yeah.
20,000 a month. Okay.
Yeah. And let me. So now financial outlay.
So the budget, sales budget that is required. That's what you're asking.
Right? Sales budget. I can call it sales budget.
Of course, sales budget will include travel other and things. All other things. Yeah.
So what should I call this?
Sales agent budget, you can say. Sales agent budget.
Sales agent budget. And this would be number of sales agents into salary per agent.
Yeah.
And again, I have to take this as.
Yeah.
Now, one of the things I wanted to point out, GV, is that when we are using some constant number like salary of the agent or sales per agent, one thing I could have done was, instead of doing it like this, I could have just said G16 into 20,000.
Ah, no, that's not a good idea.
That's not a good idea.
So
always a good idea to put the constant in a different cell. And then you refer Excel so that you can always change things easily.
Yes.
Right? So this, if you drag it now, we know that we need about 280,000 rupees per month just for sales agents.
Which is reasonable, I think, no? Given that, I don't know, I don't recall the revenue per month, but it's in crores.
It is in crores.
It might be like 1%. It looks like it's like 1% of.
What is the revenue per month? We had it here, no? Where did we go? We did it here. Yeah, this is, I should have. Well, it's not in crores. In the peak months, it's in crores, but otherwise it's in about 60 to 80 lakh range.
So 3 lakhs out of 60 lakhs
is about like 5%.
5%. Oh, that's a lot.
It is a lot, no? Yeah. If the revenue goes up to 1 crore, then it's about 3%.
Yeah. The overall sales budget, including travel, everything else, they'll have other costs, right? Like channel management and all that. So the overall cost of 8% might be okay, I think.
Yes.
Okay. Anyway, 5% looks like a lot. Okay. Anyway, we'll present it. We'll see what she has to say.
Yeah.
Maybe they don't do 5,000. Anyway, it is not 5,000. It looks like it's 4,000. Maybe you should increase it. Instead of 5, you should do some 6 or 7 or something and see what happens.
Okay. Let's do 6. It will fix, then it will drop. Then you don't need 14 agents. You can do with 11 agents.
6,000, the effective number might be still only 5,000 actually. When we saw that when 5,000, you got 4,000 something.
Effective volume handled. It's going a little above 5.
It's all right. Let it be. This is okay. Some of course, East has got 6,000.
It's a problem. So East definitely needs at least one agent more.
Yeah, I can give him one more agent. Give one more agent, put four there.
Okay, I can do that.
Something we need about optimizing.
Correct.
I'm playing around like this one. But then now it became 4,420. It's too less now. Okay, whatever. Something. Right. Some tweaks like this they can do and figure it out. Yeah. And
Now the other thing that let's just take a pause. Compute region-wise revenue for 3 months. Region-wise revenue for 3 months. Okay. So, Jeevi, all of this that we did was essentially for sales.
Yeah.
Volumes. Not for revenue. So now let's try and do it for revenue. How do we do that? So for revenue, we will need price. No?
Yeah.
Price is available in this sheet for us. Now the problem is that we may not, you know, I don't know if the price varies by month. I think price varies by month. Let's look here. We were looking at October.
Unlikely to vary. Even if it did,
varying by month. It is varying by month.
Marginally, it's varying. Governor, we just take the average of the three.
Or we can just look it up exactly. See, what I was thinking we can do is we can just look up the price here and do a sum product.
What is sum?
So.
You're trying to find the average. What are you doing? Average price, you're doing?
No. We'll do revenue. So sales into price is equal to revenue, no?
Sales into price. Yeah.
Hmm?
Okay.
So
you got sales in this table. And you got, okay, you got the sales in this table. You created this table. This table has the sales.
No. So we'll have to look at this table because we can't look at this table.
Why not?
Because this, while there's quantity, this is a mixture of quantities.
But can't I find the average price? That's not good enough. Huh?
No.
Because the, average, because the quantity is.
It will have to be weighted average of price.
That's a pain. Huh? That's not correct. Okay. I get it. All right. So let's compute that correct revenue.
So the simplest way to do it is to say, let us compute the regional revenue distribution. Okay. So regional revenue distribution. Okay. And then we'll
3 months only we need, October, November, December.
Correct. What happened?
It's not D1, it's B1. That's the problem because it's merged cell.
Yeah. Okay, and then just copy B2.
So you're just copying the table, but instead of numbers there, you're going to put
revenue,
and the revenue is going to be computed by taking that number and multiplying it by the price. The price you'll get by looking. Okay. All right.
Yes.
And since they're all in the same, because they're okay, column wise, so you can get it. We look up.
Got it. So here, what we will do is we take the maybe the quantity which is going to be C3, and you multiply it by actually sales and production will give us the price.
Yeah.
And this is coming out to be zero because we sold zero units, right? So hopefully if I drag it, then I will get the correct.
Yes.
So you're getting.
Just check the 374,8700 is correct or not.
So let's check that. So we are looking at 9865 units into 380.
Just do it in one cell, 9865 into 380. Take a free cell of Excel and do it.
Yeah. How much was it?
9865.
It's 9865.
380.
374,8700. Great.
Checks. Good.
Now, the only thing is, the price is not going to change by region. So we should put a dollar here. Right? If you see here, if I go to this sheet, this price is not varying by region.
No, it's okay. Yeah,
so we will put a dollar P there. And now the entire column I can drag.
Nice. That's nice. Definitely nice.
And then this will be my.
It's a sum, I guess.
In here, it's misbehaving. Now I will put a sum. Right? So this tells us that gear assembly one in October 2019 gave me a total revenue of 62 lakhs. Right? And so on. And I can also then do
when you said that 60 lakhs per month. So this is showing 62 lakhs just on gear assembly one. I think that revenue you are seeing was not correct, when we are looking at the revenue earlier.
Let me go back and see.
Because, I remember.
That was only for BS4.
Sorry. Totally misled. See, the bottom is the total.
No, here we can see, we can select everything. Now you will get it. In a single month, you are looking at almost 39. Yeah, sorry. 2 crores. 2 crores worth.
Put the commas, convert to currency. So see, it's three and that's what I thought. So we're doing about 4 crores. 4 crores. Okay, the lowest is about 2.6, but that's a lean month. But approximately 3 to 4 crores you're doing.
This column you should ignore, GV, because this is the sum of Jan 19 and Jan 20.
Okay.
We should only look at this.
Yeah. So 1.9, the lowest is 1 crore. Lowest is 1 crore.
Yeah.
So we should take, I think, 1.9, 2 crores you can take. That looks like 2 crores.
Correct.
So 3, 2.4 lakhs, whatever we calculated, as a percentage of 2 crores is 1 point something percent. Fantastic.
Yeah, that is no that problem. Is possible. No?
Absolutely yes. Possible. Very good. Very good.
Okay.
Yeah.
So now, of course, if I do this, then it tells you that this is 14 crores. Sorry, this was.
Yeah, because it's for. No. I'm double counting. Eh?
Yeah, it does seem to be 14 crores. How did I get that wrong? This seems to be very high. How did this happen? Oh, wait. So, no. So this has become P6 for some reason. It should be P5 only, no? No, it should be P6. P6 is correct.
It's only 1125 units. What is the price? There's something wrong with that. I mean, what is the thing? What is it saying? C4 into
some C32. These two numbers are very high. Sorry.
Because you have sold 11,200 numbers. At what price?
No, we have not sold. 11,200 is of G1. So this is coming in the wrong place. D4 into Q6. It should not be Q6, no. This is the problem. This should also be dollar. See, this is the problem if you don't put dollars correctly, GV.
But if you have some number sense, see, now you know, because you know the checking, right? You know the totals.
Now you're okay.
You know the total should be in the 2 crore benchmark. If it comes, so you'll know immediately something's wrong. Okay, we fixed it. Anyway, that's good. So now what? So
now, whole block we can copy once again for November. Only thing we have to check that is important to check is if that dollar has gone to the right place. Okay. So now this is still looking up dollar P5, which is wrong. Okay, because dollar P5 is so if you look at dollar P5, it is the price for gear assembly 1. In October. Actually, you want the price in R5. November.
Yeah.
So it has to be R5.
Yeah. So this you have to do manually because there's no obvious way of
it. It has to be done manually, unfortunately. So we will do R.
Once you do that, then the rest can be copied.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
And the same thing now we'll have to repeat for December. And again, we have to check the. So this is now looking at R5. Actually, we needed to look at
E5, I think. No? T5. Yeah.
T5. Why is this coming some value? N10. Oh, yeah, there's some.
Spurious dot in there.
Correct. Okay, now it's looking okay, right? So now we are saying that the total sales in December is 1 crore 81 lakhs. Total sales in November is 2 crores 48 lakhs. And total sales in October is 2 crores 27 lakhs.
Seems okay. Yeah.
But what is interesting now we have got is Jeevi, they also have got the regional sales.
We got the regional sales.
So you know, out of this 2 crore 27 lakhs, 62 lakhs roughly is coming from north, 71 lakhs from east, 27 lakhs almost from west, and roughly 67 lakhs from the south.
West were nothing. Actually, strange, huh? Very strange that we are not getting any revenue from the west.
Correct.
Pune being such a huge automotive place, I don't know.
Correct.
But ask why that's the case, yeah.
Correct. You should ask Shiv actually why that is.
Ace Gears.
Isn't it?
They may not have customers in the West. Maybe Mahindra is not a customer.
Or, you know, Fiat or Tata Motors may not be a customer.
Tata Motors.
Something like
that. Correct, correct.
Or the other thing that could be happening, JV, is maybe they are doing trucks. They are doing goods vehicles and not passenger vehicles.
Goods vehicles, goods vehicles, Tata's is in Jamshedpur, no?
Correct.
That's right.
Maybe it is good vehicle. Okay.